Good evening. Welcome to Newscope again. I'm Patrick Muldowney. Well, we're back again after a one-hour break. We were on the air today for more than 10 hours, bringing you Chicago's information on what was happening in the city and the surrounding area. We used the facilities of the Chicago Daily News and the Chicago Sun-Times, as well as Channel 32's own facilities, and the facility of ham radio station WA9RTP with Jim Roper and Dick Cox at the controls. We'll have a report from them later in Newscope. Here in the Chicago area, we tend to think of this as our storm. Actually, it hit most of the state and even neighboring states. For a regional weather report, we go to Harlan Draeger in the city room of the Chicago Daily News.
The snowstorm that slammed into Chicago's midsection has left a wide surrounding area in a state of near paralysis. For suburbanites, as well as city residents, the word is don't travel unless it's an absolute emergency. Toll roads still are in bad shape. Many other major routes and secondary roads are impassable. Down in the Joliet area, for example, U.S. Highway 45 and Illinois 102 and 54 are still closed down by 7-foot drifts. In that area, an elderly man trapped at his home after he'd amputated 3 fingers in a snowblower was rescued by a helicopter after a farm tractor, a snow plow, and a civil defense truck failed to get through to him. And also in Kankakee County, the U.S. Army Reserve equipment has been called out. Snow removal crews are working around the clock to clear the roads in northeastern Illinois, but they're facing an enormous task, complicated by hundreds of stalled cars and trucks. To aid in the massive snow removal task, extra equipment is being brought in from Wisconsin, where the storm didn't hit nearly as hard. About the only good news for the area is the fact that temperatures aren't dropping nearly as fast as the Weather Bureau predicted. But for thousands of suburbanites, the prospect for Saturday is plenty of exercise, digging out their cars and driveways. Harlan Draeger, Chicago Daily News.
Well, it's just about over with. Although it isn't all over with completely, because as you just heard, the temperatures are still going down. The Weather Bureau tells me that bitterly cold weather is going to hit Chicago by dawn. They say the temperature is going to go down to about 10 degrees above zero before dawn. So it isn't really all over with. The Cuddy-Sark sign across the Chicago River over there says it's 22 degrees right now, and it's still sort of going down, so I don't know what's going to happen. In Springfield today, Governor Kerner met with some officials from the National Guard. He called out all the helicopters and some of their half trucks to come up to the Chicago area and see if they can't clear up this monumental mess. Mayor Daley met for a couple of hours today with his department heads to coordinate strategy to clear the streets of the snow and ice and whatnot. The snow fell continuously for 29 hours and 8 minutes. According to the Weather Bureau, it was more than 23 inches deep. It's probably a lot deeper than that in front of your house if it's drifting at all. Actually, there are some places where the drifts are more than 15 feet deep. I talked to one reporter earlier who said that he got home and it was 4.5 feet deep in front of his front door. In his backyard, the wind had sort of cleared it all away, so all he could see was grass. It's just sort of a weird situation. There were at least 29 people killed in the storms through various things or another. Most of these, of course, were victims of heart attacks, people who suffered heart attacks while shoveling snow in front of their walks. Everyone here has gone home. You turn around, the city room is just about empty. We only ran one edition after our first tonight, having a lot of trouble, of course. Circulation trucks just couldn't get to the newsstand, so if you don't have a paper, you have to go out and buy one, I suppose. The overall effect of this storm was just stupendous. For us in the newspaper business, it was frequently a question of trying to ferret out all the good news from the bad news, the good stuff from the bad stuff. It was just a race. Chicago, the nation's transportation center, was paralyzed. All the airports were closed today. They probably won't be open much before 4:30. I think that's what O'Hare said. Midway told us earlier they were going to be open about noon. The thing to do on that, of course, if you are planning to fly, and if you do have a reservation, call the airlines if you have a chance. Even long-distance trains were arriving 2 to 4 hours late today. One of the few ways to get anywhere, I think, from all the reports we've had, is the CTA's rapid transit. The trains are running pretty much on time. The buses, of course, are quite another matter. Last night, one of our reporters told us it took him 5 hours to get from the office to about Fullerton and Clark. 5 hours. storm's effect on food stores was almost immediate. Local supermarkets reported their shelves were clear of milk, meat, bread, and cigarettes. Their staff couldn't get to work. Stores said they'll be open tomorrow, and they're going to try to supply them, but, of course, that's problematical at this point. Door-to-door milk deliveries were abandoned, pretty much. But for the children, the storm was fun. My two nephews live out in Inverness. We're building Viet Cong tunnels through the snow while their parents, my brother and sister-in-law, were inside drinking brandy. More than 500 teachers and students spend the night in schools. They're still snowbound. Although there was some looting in some places on the west side tonight, most of the city's residents were pretty well-behaved, according to most people we talked to. This looting occurred on the west side predominantly. A 10-year-old girl, Dolores Miller, was shot to death as police exchanged gunfire with some looters in a shoe store on West Roosevelt Road. Police arrested more than 65 people on the west side today and tonight. The days off were canceled for all off-duty policemen. A lot of the trouble, of course, was generated by the inability of the police to get to wherever the trouble was. Although most Chicago area hospitals were operating well today, some were getting along with full staffs. Now, if you have any activities that you're planning to go to tonight or tomorrow, it's best to check with them. Right behind me, I have a list that's longer than a sleepless night of various activities that aren't going to be held. So check with them and just cool it, because everything that can be done is being done. I'm Dick Foster at the City Room of the Chicago Sun-Times.
I think he had to go. There was no one else to answer the telephone. Today we presented the longest weather report ever run on a Chicago television station, but it wouldn't be complete unless we gave you a different look at the weather. We'll take a look through the eyes of the Sun-Times and Chicago Daily News cameramen. This is how they saw the super snow in Chicago. That came from, but if that wasn't Chicago today, if it was California, they had temperatures up in the 80s, and the same in Florida.